feel like this is like old school YouTube right here. Worked out. My butt's sore. Hi. Is this a good shot? I can't tell. Today's video is a video that I've actually wanted to shoot for a while now. Maybe I should speak English. Maybe that would help. I don't know if any of you are following me on Instagram, but you should. But probably 8 months ago, I put on Instagram that I wanted you guys to send me your favorite clothing recommendations from Amazon. And I wanted to wear all of the recommended outfits that you picked out for me for a week and test them out. I got a ton of responses. I mean, I literally couldn't go through all of them. There were so many. Well, because of contractual issues, I wasn't really able to film that video. But I still have all the stuff that you guys recommended. And it's just been sitting in my house in this box for months. Will Amazon let me return some of this stuff? Is it too late? Let me know in the comments what you think. Another disclaimer here is I know it's winter time and I ordered these back in spring, so a lot of these have a lot of spring summer flair to them. But it's never too early to start planning for your next vacation. Lord knows we all need a vacation right now. I ordered a variety of stuff. Some of these are not my style. I really wanted to order things that I probably wouldn't order for myself. Some of these outfits were recommended to me by multiple people. I spent like $250 or something. Let's jump in. I've got nothing else to do with my time. First up is this dress. It is kind of this vintage 1930s flare dress. It's made by a brand called Belle Poque. Poque? Pokey. Poque? Let me know. I wasn't really sure about this dress, you guys, because it is so curly and conservative. I'm gonna go pick flowers out of a flower patch. They're not called flower patches. Gardens? Fields? Looks like you're gonna go pick flowers with a basket in your hand wearing this thing. This kind of gives me like mom in the 1940s cooking dinner at 5 p.m. vibes, which there's nothing wrong with that, but it's just not really my vibe. When I put this outfit on, it looked so cute. I want to be a mom in the 1940s cooking dinner at 5 p.m. in this thing. It's really comfortable. I was very surprised at the quality of the fabric. It's very thick, but it also has like a stretchy vibe too. I ordered this in a size small, and it actually might be a smidge too big for me, which is kind of weird. I usually get smalls or mediums in dresses. I love how colorful it is. It actually came in a couple of other different colors and patterns. There was one dress that came with like lemons on the front, which is really cute. It kind of feels a little costumey, I'm not gonna lie. Like it looks like you're getting ready to go to a bop. What they called dances back then? I love this dress. I think it's a dress that's like perfect for like a family outing. One thing to know is that the buttons on this thing are not actually real buttons, which kind of annoys me. I also wish the collar was like a smidge lower. Call me a little hussy, but I like a little like cleave, you know what I mean? Not a lot of cleave, but just like a little peekaboo cleave, and this definitely gives you no cleave. Whoever recommended this to me, thank you so much. The next one, on to the next one, on to the next one. This little two-piece number. This outfit makes me want a pina colada. Pina colada? Pina colada? It's like the English language has just escaped my mind as soon as I started to film this video. This makes me want to lay on the beach, get a tan, drink a pina colada. Or a daiquiri. I'll just go daiquiri. That's easier. I thought it looked really cute, but usually things that are cute on Amazon are usually too good to be true. But in this case, I actually liked this one. This is like 100% polyester. It's very stretchy. It does look a little cheap. I'm not gonna lie. I really hate it when you can see where the seams are like sewn in a different color than the fabric. It makes it look really cheap. And it definitely looks like the print was printed on stretchy material. It hits your curve. It kind of expands and doesn't look really good. It's really soft and really light. If you have a curvy body like I do, where I'm a little bit smaller around the waist and real curvy on the bottom, this accentuates that figure. I think it's really sexy. I love that there's the wraparound waist part of this top. I don't know if I wrapped it properly, but I think you could wrap it a bunch of different ways. My only major complaint about this look is that the skirt's too short. I'm like 5'8", and I do have trouble finding pants and skirts that are long enough for me. If this was like another inch or 2 inches longer, I actually think I'd keep this. Something in my mouth. Moving on to a dress that really was one of the most requested dresses that I got sent via Instagram. Actually, my girlfriend Blair Fowler. Oh, I can't talk today. Yeah. Why? Why are words so hard? So this dress was recommended to me by my girlfriend, Blair Fowler. A bunch of you sent this dress to me, and then she sent this dress to me, and she's like, girl, you need this dress. It's this little, very plain looking cocktail dress, but when you put this thing on, it really hugs you in all the right places. I don't know what it's made of. I think it's probably polyester. I ordered it in a size 4. I probably should have ordered it in a size 6. It was a smidge too tight. There was no room in here for a bra, so I couldn't wear a bra, and it is kind of thin material, so if you're out and about in the world, just know that your nipples might come out to say hello. I love that it's fitted right around your waist, which is obviously the smartest part of your body. Smartest part? That actually might be the smartest part of my body. The smallest part of your body. This dress, you guys, has one of my favorite things ever. It has pockets. I think I'm genetically predispositioned to love pockets. It's kind of like the cilantro gene, or the gene that has like your second toe bigger than your first toe. I have a gene where I'm attracted to pockets. It's genetic, it's science. I was born this way. Like this video if you also have the gene for pockets. The only bad thing about this dress is that it wrinkles so easily. Okay, so this next find is very strange. I think it will tell you a lot about how weird I actually am. So I think a lot of you submitted outfits that were ridiculous that you thought would be really funny to see me wearing out and about in life. I ordered this thinking, oh, this will be a joke and this is gonna be really ugly because the photo was oogly. So I got it here and I pulled it out and it looked so disgusting. It looked like some sort of water painting from when I was a kid, or an aquarium. It looked like it smelled really bad, but it was brand new, so it didn't. I was like, what the ever-loving heck is this? I was like, you know what? I'm gonna put it on because the people asked for it. And you guys, I loved it. I don't know why I loved it, because it looks horrendous on camera, but in person, I thought it looked really cute. Gave me like carpenter, train conductor, painter, Aladdin vibes. It has like the harem pants with the drop crotch with pockets. It had the overalls like my grandpa used to have on the farm. I just loved it. If you're a painter, you need to wear this, because this is a legit painter's outfit. If you showed up at my house gonna paint some stuff wearing this, I'd be like, I trust your vision. Whatever you say, you do it, because clearly you know more about this than I do. There's something legitimizing about this outfit. I'm gonna paint my house in this, and I'm gonna invite my neighbors over to watch me do it, because I'm gonna be like, watch this artist in action. Jealous. Moving on to something that looks like I bought it at a sex shop. This is a little skirt that comes with this built-in grid system and suspenders. I don't really know how one would explain this. I think it's predominantly a skirt with extracurriculars. What? I think you're supposed to wear it with like a bodysuit or a t-shirt. It is very cheaply made, but it looks really cute on, and I was really surprised. Two problems I had was that these straps were way too long. You could get those altered though pretty easily. And the bottom skirt was not the most flattering fit. It kind of looks boxy and makes you look wide. The concept is cute, the execution is just not there. They have these in other colors, so if you're like a short, petite person and you like this look, I think it's close. Again, I'm 5'8". This is way too short. My butt falls out the back. And I can't blame my height on that. I blame my butt size. Moving on to my last and final piece. This one I'm really excited about, mostly because it's very strange and I would probably never order it myself, so I'm so glad you guys made me order it. It is this black mesh dress. It has these embroidered flowers. Embroidered is such a hard word to say. It has long sleeves and it has this little like mock turtleneck situation. The only problem is this thing doesn't really stretch very much, and if you have a big head like me, you may struggle a lot. Where are my big headed people at? Comment in the comments. This dress reminds me of like Coachella. It's kind of not as edgy and cool as Coachella, but if you have FOMO because you can't go to Coachella and you're at your office and you're like, I still want to celebrate, this is your happy medium where HR is not going to be triggered by your outfit. Again, the only thing about this is it's 100% polyester. Actually, it says it's 30% cotton, but I think that is the flowers. And weirdly, even though this is mesh, when I put it on, the heat in my body started getting trapped in it, and I started to sweat, and I was like, oh my gosh, this could be a smelly, sweaty situation. My organic deodorant can only go so far. This is gonna push it to the limits. If you find yourself in a non-sweaty situation, this would be a really cute look. I think you could pair it with like shorts or black leather pants, or even even like a hot black bodysuit if you are going to Coachella. I'm gonna find a place to wear it. I actually don't think I'm gonna send this one back. I'm gonna keep it. Well, that is it, you guys, for this video where you on Instagram helped pick out my outfits from Amazon. Sorry it was such a long time coming to all of those who've been messaging me being like, did you order it? Like, what's the status? You know, life got in the way, or other people got in the way. Did you like this video concept? Do you want me to do this again where I actually go out and wear the outfits? Should I do like a winter round of this? Let me know in the comment section below, you guys. If you haven't yet, follow me on Instagram so you can know when I do other videos like this and you can help me become a better adult. Also subscribe, hit the notifications. I've been doing Vlogmas for the last 20 days or so. You should click right over here to catch yesterday's Vlogmas where I took my family to do an awkward 80s, 90s inspired family photo. It's pretty funny, and you also get to meet my family and you get to see Ern in her natural habitat. Love you. I will see you in the next video, which is probably tomorrow, hopefully, God willing. It's Vlogmas.